stand his post. He's taking a road bike to the Mudbilly down in Devon. He's taking a little Mazda.
I bought this thing 2 years ago, £500, for a banger race during COVID, which unfortunately was cancelled. So it's just kind of sat here. I did have intentions of doing it up and restoring it. It needs £2,500 of welding on the chassis. Now, the idea with this video is to make that into an off-roader, because everybody else will be taking Land Rover Discoveries, Defenders, Suzuki Jimneys. I'm going to take a Mazda that I'm going to turn into a dune buggy. Right, hopefully we can just pull it out a wee bit. Oops. This isn't going to go.
It's not going to plan so far, that's touching. Oh, for f***ing sake. Why can't you not just come straight?
Oh man, she's a sorry wee car, eh? She's a sorry wee car.
Oh, jeez, AP1. Oh, it's not looking good, eh? It's not looking good.
So obviously the first problem we have, when it got recovered, it did in fact pretty much get hot wired to get recovered. So we're going to need to try and put this back together now that we obviously have the key. And take it from there, I guess. Alright, I'm not quite sure if I've done this right, but I wired this wee panel in because the ignition's not working. And I think I might have done it right. Obviously it is indicating. Oh, I thought that was something blowing up. But look.
Yes!
Yes, boys! She starts! I can't even believe I actually just did that. I wired up a switch panel and got it to work. That's making a bit of noise, man. Obviously, we'll give it an oil change and shit as well, because fuck knows how long that oil's been in there. But now that we know it runs, that's a good sign. Alright, so it is running completely by itself now. The battery pack has been taken off. We're just going to give it a wee drive forward. Right, let's hope we don't break the clutch yet, but he's gone, she's gone, she's gone. Oh mate, that's so fun, eh? I can't believe she's gone.
Well, now that she starts, she gets an honorary clean. As you can tell, she's a wee bit dirty, wee bit mossy.
So we'll give her a nice wee clean up, and then tomorrow we'll start the proper preparations on getting this thing ready for Mudbilly. I cannot believe I got this started. It's been sitting in my yard for 2 years, doing nothing, and now it works. Alright, so obviously last night we got it running and I thought I'd cleaned it, but as you can see I really haven't. But anyways, plan is today we're going to rip out the interior, rip out the seats, get it back to bare metal, get it all prepped, 6-point harness, bucket seats, 3-point harness bar, 3-point harness, 3-point harness, and then that's the inside done and nice and safe. And then in the back I want to do a fuel cell and sort the battery and just lose as much weight as possible in the back as well. It's got, you know, I mean, it's all bits of shite and stuff, but just get as much weight off it as we can. We're then going to give it a 3-inch lift, big chunky tyres, obviously cut out the arch to allow for these chunky tyres, same on the front, cut off a bit of the back so the bumper doesn't catch all the time, or maybe even just take the back bumper off, snorkel, get it ready for off-road. It's going to be good. Alright, so just looking in at the seats here, there's a load of rubbish, I do apologise. As you can see, the reason we're getting rid of the carpet as well is it's well, I'm trying to show you here actually, it's absolutely soaking. Don't know if you can see all that water, so that's going to be holding a lot of weight, but it's also going to be rusting against the chassis. And I'd like to find out if there's a hole in the floor pan, right about now rather than later. Alright, so we've got the old soggy Mazda seats out. Look, you can see they're just starting to grow green. Oh, that's soggy. That gives us a hell of a lot more room in here.
Hopefully you can kind of see the wet of the water a bit better now. I'm just hoping that's not rusty, but let's be honest, it probably will. In fact, that might be easy just to find out right then. Oh, look at that. Not at all. Oh, that is lucky, but aye, pretty much what we're going to do now. I'm going to go get a styling blade and just start ripping this all out. Make sure I don't lose my fucking ratchet. And aye, just rip out all the carpet, cut it all out. Clean it all out. Dry this all, paint it all, prep it all. Good to go. Alright, we're getting in quite deep. As you can see, it's a wee bit wet in here. But luckily it's not rusty, it's all pretty goddamn solid. Which is what I was worried about. Obviously we'll take all this off. Just get as much weight as possible. Not that it'll make much difference, but you know.
It's quite a satisfying job, this one, to be honest. I'm sure it's probably the most satisfying and the only satisfying job. I just like ripping panels out.
Just gotta cut out as much of the interior as we can, because some things are held in by bolts. I know I'm taking the seat belts out, but it's just so much easier just to cut the hole. There we go. Again, there. Oh, my finger. Slowly but surely. All right, there's no turning back now. Next, we're taking out the steering wheel, the seat belts, because we're putting a 3-point in, and as much weight out as it as we can. We're also taking the convertible side out. We're stripping the frosties off. Making good tracks so far. Now, the reason I'm getting rid of this is, I'll show you, the actual window glass itself is no longer attached, so it would need restitched. So as you can see, it's no longer attached there. So I couldn't, they wouldn't let me drive a bit like that, because it's all just ripping and faded. So it needs to come off anyways, just in case you think, or screaming, oh, you could be selling this stuff, it's all wet, and, you know what I mean?
Still very much attached to the bottom of the car. It's not going back on now, that's for sure. Ah, so it's all attached via bolts and stuff to the bottom. Oh! Oh!
Oh, right, there's no going back now, that's it all stripped out. We've even taken the surround out that we cut originally to get the convertible out. There's a bit of that chair there, and also all of these parts that came out of the Mazda. Jesus, that's a bit of weight reduction. Obviously, we'll probably put the same back in again by the time we put the roll cage in, the bucket seats, all that jazz. The same will probably go back in. At least that way we're not adding more weight, we're just kind of offsetting. Alright, so here's where we're at right now. As you can see, it's a wee bit on, but everything is all clean and we're just going to get ready for paint. Alright, we are losing light, but I've got a wee hour left before I have to pick up this roll cage, so we're just going to quickly go ahead and spray bits so that it's nice and rust-proofed now that it is nice and dried out. And of course, in my cupboard from when I was restoring the Mazda, I have a half-empty can of the Mazda Blue along with two other full ones. I'm telling you, this is going to seem scripted, but honestly, the majority of parts I have for this MX5 have been sitting in storage for like 2 or 3 years. You can't write it. Oh, right, so I've driven an hour and 15 minutes up to Edinburgh here to pick up, well, an hour and a half more so, to pick up this roll cage for the MX5. All right, roll cage picked up, and it's a sign. It's already comes pre-fitted with a GoPro mount. It's a sign. That's us back to Edinburgh, done for today. I'm not gonna lie, I'm feeling a bit sick. Hopefully we're fine for tomorrow though. Right, what's the next day? Last night was horrible. I was hot and cold, constantly feeling sick. Missy says I was talking in my sleep. Don't know what happened yesterday, but I am just not feeling good. Even today, I'm not feeling good, but either sit in the house and feel sorry for yourself all day, or get out and do something, keep your mind busy. So as you can tell, that's the option we picked. Let's go get this roll cage fitted. Alright, here's the roll cage. Got side bars, all sorts, ready to go. Obviously it is pre-used, but it's never actually been used, it's never been rolled. So we should be okay. Alright, so obviously last night we painted it, so it's all nice and rust-proofed. And then that way, the rust isn't sitting anywhere. What I've noticed, a small note, just coming in, there is a wee puddle formed here. And I'd quite like to know who that's Kate. Why is it?
Ha! That puddle's been in there when I've painted it, and I've just painted over it. Oh, jeezy beeps, man. Well, never mind. That puddle hasn't came in last night. It was obviously dark last night when I was painting it, and I've just painted it over the top of it. Hey, let's do a little trial fit of the roll cage. I need to find a good angle for you to be at. That is probably the best angle we're going to get. Let's see how we trial fit. We're obviously still keeping this on because I'm going to get one of those flags that says like Bridgestone RC cars. I quite like this wee bit. Alright, so it's not quite as simple as just bolting straight off the bat. There's going to have to be a bit of cutting to be done. So we're going to need to pretty much go in here and down a bit. And I'm assuming once we get back past all this, it's going to be a subframe of some sort. And then that way we'll be able to bolt it right down into maybe something a little bit harder than just this sheet metal. Because right now, we're a few inches off. Weight reduction. Oh, it's been ages since I've used a grinder. Alright, so hopefully you can see what I've done. Now I have cut it a lot more than what it needs to be, but the reason for that is just purely looks. If you imagine it, it's only going to sit there, so really I didn't need to cut this bit. But it meant that when I bolt that down, there would just be a bit of, you know, this bit of steel here would just be flapping about. So I cut it right back to where it's actually sitting. And I just feel like that will look a hell of a lot nicer. Then that way I've not got a bit of flappy steel that's just flapping about. So aye, that's that bit. We'll go tidy up that side and then pretty much do the exact same. Take out this rubber foam so we can get right down to the steel. Start drilling holes. So we'll get the first bit of the roll cage done. We've just bolted it in to where the seatbelt mounts were before. So I'm quite glad I took the seatbelts out. So it turns out the seatbelt needs to come out for that bolt to go in anyways. Or maybe we could have just sandwiched it on top. But aye, that's that bit done. We'll just do the drillings now for here, here and here. And then we'll do the spreader plates. Get that one all fitted. All ready to get fitted, sorry. Fit the top bit, make sure there's no adjustment needing done. And then put the final bolts in. Alright, that's all I can do now. Basically just drilled the holes. Then I'll come and mount it through this hole in here. But I need to go for a gender scanner now. Not to find out what gender I'm, to find out what gender the chair I'm having is. So she's all in a little bit. Right, safety squint.
Obviously I've picked the only place for any light, but that is it fitted down there. We've got the door bars in there, cut back in, into there. Obviously that for the harness bar, but I have to cut that down a wee touch. And aye, there she is. And bloody solid, beautiful. Alright, again, not much in the way of light. There is a, as you can see, there's lights the whole way down. The one place I've put the Mazda, no light. But here we are, coming into the harnesses now. So as you can see, we're just setting up on the harness bar. And then of course we've got the harnesses wired into the floor down there and there. Now we're just pre-fitting that. We'll put the bucket seat on top and hopefully it should be a pretty easy process. Alright, so going back to the Sparkle belts and the harnesses and obviously the bucket seat mount. And I'm really against using this bucket seat for the race. I bought these 2 years ago, 3 years ago. I can't quite remember when I bought the Mazda, when I had no other financial problems. I must have spent about £6,000 all in with the car and such, and just bought loads and loads of shite. And one of the things I bought with the bucket seats, and I don't know why, I always kept hold of them, because I always knew that I was going to do the Mazda again when I came into money, like YouTube money or something, because it needs like quite a bit of welding. And that's just welding. It needs a lot. To put it back on the road, it needs a lot. But to put it a track car, doesn't need that much. But aye, I'll leave that upset about putting these in, because they're such nice, you know what I mean? They're just going to all dirty and shit, but that's life, innit? That's life. I think they're about 350 quid each, these bucket seats too. I always thought about selling them and getting my money back, but I don't know why. I don't know why I kept them. But if you don't believe me, here's my little cupboard through here. And this is where I just keep loads and loads of stuff. There's mud flaps for lorries, there's a Sparkle neck brace in there. It's just spits and bobs, just, you know what I mean? A license plate for the thing, there's another Sparkle seatbelt cover, there's curtains for lorries in there, it's just a lot of stuff in there. So, I don't want to use them, but what's the point in going out and, because another bucket seat's about 100 quid anyway, so what's the point in going out and buying a used bucket seat for 100 quid when I can use these ones potentially kind of for free in a sense? Not really, but you know what I mean. All right, so roll cage is installed, harness is installed. We do have a second bucket seat and harness. I don't have enough bolts to fit that one today, but I might fit that at a later date. Not that I plan on taking passengers at the weekend, but it would be nice to have the option. As you can see, all nice and fitted. If I just grab the Milwaukee torch here, as you can see, still no light. As you can see, that's it, all nice and fitted. Obviously, we've had to do a bit of chopping there to fit the harness bar in, a bit of chopping to fit the bill bar in, the roll bar in, but hey, not a bad wee setup. Not a bad wee setup. Obviously I changed it so that it's as far back as it can physically go. It's still quite tight, but it's a lot better than what it was. And also, I tried to jack it up. Still was a wee bit of paper. But the chassis is actually not bad. Obviously I've been under the car today, and the chassis itself is actually quite solid. Even just the bottom floor pans and stuff are all quite good. It's just the sills, unfortunately, have gotten a bad end of the rust. Now, another modification that I wouldn't have done if I didn't have it, but here is a hard top I bought again 2-3 years ago. And if you don't believe me, look at all that dust that's on there, you know what I mean? That's fresh out of storage, you know what I mean? Just in case folk are thinking, oh, that's a scripted. Honestly,
the whole reason I decided to build this Mazda for this Mudbilly is because the amount of parts I knew that I already had sitting in
the warehouse and in my storage cupboard. Obviously the seats, I mean the seats could have went in anyone, and so could that harness, to be fair. The roll cage we had to buy, but just silly things like, you know, to be fair, actually the quick release probably fits in any car as well.
Yeah, I don't have much of an excuse.
The hard top, you know what I mean?
But if I'm being honest with you, I think it would just be really cool to see this Mazda go around the track. So I'm just going to quickly check the hard top fits. And then that is us done for this episode. Because if I don't go home now, I'm not have a girlfriend to go home to.
No, it does fit, sorry. It's just when the window was closed there, the seal wasn't right.
Oh, boys, I can't believe the hard top.
I can't believe the hard top fits. How nice does that look with a hard top on it? Oh, God. That is gorgeous. Obviously, we'll paint it and colour match it right now. I think I might have bought it off of someone who likes a bit of glitter. So we'll definitely get that painted.
There's no way I'm going to this mud run
with a glittery. A glittery top.
It's already as bad that I'm going in a hairdresser's car.
But look at that, boys. She's getting there. She's looking a bit sorry. I don't know why that eye's down. It kind of looks like she's covering a bit. But
she's getting there. She's getting there. This weekend, we go and pick up the big beefy tyres. AMT are going to powder coat them and get everything all ready. And then we'll get to cutting the arches, putting hopefully some suspension in. And at the end, I would like to turbo it, but I don't know if I've got the money to turbo it. But if that happens, it's all going to happen here on the YouTube channel. Thank you all for watching. Don't forget to rate, comment, subscribe. And as always, we'll see you guys in the next video, where we're either trucking or building Mazdas.